Hello, everyone. So let's start this season up. I guess I've been playing spring training. I always end up doing that accidentally. I always forget to simulate it. Season takes too long to go through that. So it appears this weekend I will be going to Cedar Point for the weekend, so won't have anything out this weekend. But I kind of want to, after I'm done here with MLB, I'll probably want to do some multiplayer in Uncharted 4. Because, of course, I'm a huge Uncharted fan.
The crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
Like Killzone,
we give you a look at AJ Hinch's Astros lineup. Steve, what's their focus as they go for their first win?
Well, they're facing a guy today that throws a lot of strikes, so you're going to have to be aggressive early in the count, but get the ball up in the zone. Shorten up a little bit, put the ball in play.
Swing and a miss, looked like the slider there, a ball and a strike. The temperature here at game time still definitely on the cool side, 51 degrees at first pitch. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now.
Boy, that's just pretty standard operating procedure right here. You get him leaning out over the plate on that slider running away, and then you
nice
inside hard on that fastball.
All right, good start.
And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Gray into his motion. First pitch on its way. Charlie Blackman is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Tried to shoot the corner, and he missed it. 2-2.
All right.
Hit hard, and that is through into center field for a one-out single.
Batting third.
Prince Fielder takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Runners off for second. Pitch swung out and missed the throw. Not in time as he steals second. One out and a runner on second base. And he falls behind 0-2. Fought off at the plate and will do it again. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
You got to be careful with that inside location on 0-2. The last thing you want to do is hit him.
And this one gets away. Throw goes to third. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. Has to be thinking strikeout here. Might have jammed him a little there as this is softly hit and foul off to the left. He's set. Here's the 3-2 on the ground to the left side.
Get him.
Only play will be to first as we'll see our first run score here as this is a 1-0 ball game.
The left fielder number two,
Chris Davis. Bats now and will try to start over with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground out. Lays off 1-0. And, ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1. Makeup call there?
I don't know, but let's just say they're even.
1-2 now as that's in there at the knees. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Inciarte moves over. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. With that, it's time to check out the starting lineup for the hometown Yankees. Steve, what's the key for him against one of the best starters in the game?
Well, they're already down by one after the top of the first, so you've got to get yourself right back into this ballgame. Punch back a little bit and see if you can get your crowd back in.
Josh Harrison is at the plate as he watches ball one. That evens it up 1-1. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line.
Oh, nice. The homer.
A wall scraper, awesome. But it counts just the same. A home run.
Batting second.
So it's a solo home run to lead off the bottom of the first. And the Yankees
have
gone even now at one apiece. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
Well, for me, it's a little surprising so far that as good as these two pitchers are, both of them have had trouble in the very first inning.
Chop foul right at home plate. 1-2, here it comes. To two balls and two strikes now.
Oh, come on.
Got him swinging for the first out. Striding into the box, Josh Donaldson. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Josh Donaldson.
Foul tip into the catcher's glove at strike one.
And these guys already have one home run here in the inning, and now you get to the real power guys here. So you need to be careful.
Tap foul at home plate. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Ah, trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Grounded back up the middle. Throw on to fielder for out number two.
Batting court.
AJ Pollock gets his first opportunity now, trying to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Hit hard and short. Lindor takes it in. Throw to fielder at first. He'll take care of him, and that'll be that. But the Yankees are able to tie things up on the solo. Francisco Lindor makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
You know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off an inning for you. He makes good contact, and he can run.
And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
God,
hit the
dang
other
it.
Way, and it's into the gap. Around first, heading for second now. And he's not stopping. He wants three. Make it in safely as he kicks off the second with a leadoff triple. Coming to the plate now, Nick Castellanos. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two.
And you know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. And that's a good job of recognizing off-speed and then holding back on the swing.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. So a definite RBI spot here. Runner at third, one away. And here's the versatile outfielder, Shane Victorino. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. That's taken for a ball, and it's 1-1 now to the Astros right fielder.
Oof. That high fastball is definitely a pitch guys will pop up, and that's what he's looking for on the mound. So that's good restraint to hold back and not swing.
And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Gray sets. He'll try to put him away here on 2-2. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. Swung on in the
oh
my
the God.
And it goes without saying,
I pressed
but
the wrong button.
Well, this
that
team
is
defensively
right there, wasn't
gonna
it?
Say a lot about how they fare this year. They made it a big priority in spring training, so you hate to see him start making errors here on opening day.
Caleb Joseph is the batter now as he looks at a ball, 1-0. Fastball at 94 miles an hour, and it's 1-1.
And you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. He
there
got him. And it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Darwin Barney gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
Oh, come on.
Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Boy, what a nice job so far of working himself into a hitter's
dude.
Spot. Now he can go to work on maybe picking up that two-out RBI out of the nine hole.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
Yeah, he needed that one to avoid loading the bases, but it's still a long road back from here.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
Come
on the ground, up the middle. Backhand.
Come on. Yes.
On the first, the Astros can't cash in as that ends the inning.
That's close.
Eric Hosmer will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. Swing and a line. Foul.
Stupid curveball always gets me.
That misses wide. 1 ball and 1 strike. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. 2 balls and a strike. Here it is.
There
we
go.
Shot towards the hole and a base hit. So the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Batting six.
Settling in now, Yasiel Puig, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. This could be two. One there. On to fielder, and they turn to a double play.
Batting seven.
Ender Inciarte gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half. Line hard toward right center.
Go.
That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Stephen Vogt set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
Runners on the move for second. Pitches a called strike. The throw.
Nice.
Not in time. He's in there at second. Oh, and one count and the pitch. Home plate. Joseph gonna have to hurry, and the stolen base winds up as a move. A look there at the most famous urban park in the United States, Central Park, set to go again here from Yankee Stadium. Jose Altuve will dig in for a second time, a strikeout victim opening up the ball game.
As bad as he looked on that breaking ball his first at bat,
dang it,
he's going to see nothing but breaking balls in this one.
Third inning starts with a slider that's looked at here for ball one.
Well, here's a little trivia for you, Matt. On May 1st of 2012, Jose Altuve faced Mets pitcher John Roush, who's 6 feet 11 inches tall. The foot and a half height differential is said to be the most in MLB history between a pitcher and batter.
Nice. One away here to begin the third. Charlie Blackmon strides in after getting a base hit and later scoring the first time around.
Oh my God.
Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. One oh pitch is a slider, swung on and missed, one and one. Chopped down the first baseline, but it's a foul ball, says the first base umpire. Gray has his target. Here's the 1-2. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Prince Fielder. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired.
Shift worked.
Astros go down 1-2-3. Home half of the third coming up, tied at one.
For the Yankees, designated hitter C.J. Cron.
Grounded down the third baseline, but this is foul for the first strike. Skied into straightaway right.
Darn it.
And this is taken in out there by Victorino for out number one.
The batter number 22,
Josh Harrison, will stand in to try to duplicate his first at bat where he homered to open the inning.
It's great when he gets out there and get things going like he did. Really gets the rest of the team.
Davis is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Jonathan Villar is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
Now a swing and a third straight fly ball here.
Should
get the inning 1-2-3.
God dang it, I got three good hits on the ball. We're all flying.
Yankees retired on just four. Chris Davis is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat, because you know he has big time power.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one.
Darn it.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Yeah, trying to go front door with that breaking ball. Started it a little too far inside, though.
In the dirt. It's 3-0 now. That's on the outer edge, 3-1. No leadoff walk just yet as that finds the strike zone, and the count comes full at 3-2.
Yeah, and he's trying to make sure that he doesn't allow that first
ball.
He's worked it back to full count now after being behind in the count, 3-0.
Into the box now, Francisco Lindor, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. He records his
first
goal of the year here on opening day. And that's through into center field. Oh, and he misses the stop sign there as he heads for the plate.
My God.
He's in there at the plate. Now in the box, Nick Castellanos. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind, 0-2. That fastball straightens him up a bit, 1-2 now. Two runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And tough fastball to lay off on 1-2, but he did, and it's 2-2 now. And he's retired here, one away. Shane Victorino comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time. And a slider tails outside for ball one. Any thought to bringing the infield in here with one away?
still no, you.
In my book.
And he's going to score with ease as the.
Oh, come on.
The catcher, Caleb Joseph, is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Squared that one up just a little late. 0-1, here's the pitch. In the dirt here.
I'm about to take Sonny Gray out.
Fortunately here, no advance. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Oh, looked like he was towing an anchor there, 1-2.
He might have thought he'd be getting another dose of that curveball because he was way behind that one.
Runner at first here, one man out. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
You know, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Now batting. Darwin Barney stands in. He's 0-1 after grounding out. Into the seats, 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Ready with the 0-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
Reined in. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Josh Donaldson is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Well, should be 2-0, but he goes way out of the zone to go after that one, and it's even 1-1.
Josh Donaldson is, of course, one of the greatest players in the game today. But before he was a pro, he had a really nice college career at Auburn, the same program that has turned out other greats such as Frank Thomas, Bo Jackson, and Timmy Hudson.
Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Yeah, Donaldson primarily played catcher at Auburn, where he was a preseason All-American and an All-Star in the prestigious Cape Cod League.
Yeah, and it's no surprise that he got to play in that Cape League. So many of the major's best players have come through that summer league, and it's really become one of the most treasured aspects of amateur baseball. If you're a baseball fan, it's definitely worth checking out the Cape to go down there to watch baseball.
Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike. And a curveball is by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
Well, if he's going to overcommit to pitches like that down in the zone, I'd keep throwing him until he proves he can lay off.
This one's flared toward left center. Lindor ranging into the outfield. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. Eric Hosmer is the batter. Got a base hit in his first trip.
Eric Hosmer.
Hit hard back up the middle. And that's through for a hit. And now he has some trouble with it in center. Yasiel Puig will dig in. 0-1 in the ballgame. Tanaka pauses. Here comes the first pitch. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate. Hot shot to the third. But gloved by the third baseman for the out.
Up next for the Yankees,
Ender Inciarte gets a shot here with two on and two out here in the fourth.
And a big two out at bat right here. You know, it's still early in this game, but you don't want to have to look back on this as a major missed opportunity later on.
Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Very weakly on the ground, but that one rolls foul. And he starts to go after it. Question was, did he hold up in time? Yes, indeed, says the third base umpire. The 1-2 pitch. Hard liner towards short. And that's in there. Base hit.
Finally.
Around third and being waved on home. And the runner scores from second as they cut away into that deficit here. It's now a 3-2 contest. So striding in, Stephen Vogt, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
This is not the time to go helping him out. You got two men in scoring position, so the pressure's on him, not you.
Oh, and you're talking about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now. Do you even bother with anything else here?
No, I sure wouldn't. As a hitter, you're thinking, look for fastball, adjust for an off-speed pitch. And so far in this at-bat, he hasn't made any adjustments.
Swung
on. And that's the final out of the inning. Yankees strike for a run on the RBI double. Jose Altuve will stand in now. He took home the Silver Slugger Award in the American League a year ago. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone and it's probably going to finish out of the zone. So that's a good job just to lay off.
There now is Pollock, and he's got it for the first out.
The batter,
Charlie Blackmon, will stand in now. He singled and struck out in two trips. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You can tell here, in his mind, he's thinking, quick inning. He's not even trying to set guys up. He's coming right after them.
And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth.
First baseman, number 80.
So two are gone for the Astros in the fifth, and that'll bring in the slugging first baseman, Prince Fielder. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. Seems like he's gotten away with more than a few location mistakes so far.
Yeah, and that's not going to last forever, especially in this place.
Moving under it, Puig. Okay. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. Leading off the inning, CJ Cron, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Tanaka gets the sign. Here comes the pitch. Liner to second. Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done. Josh Harrison strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Now a line to the left side. Foul. The windup and the 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Left field and deep. Davis going back, but he won't get there. It falls in. The relay. And he
Beats
a throw into second as he slides in safely with a one-out double.
Up next for the Yankees.
So stepping in, Jonathan Villar, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead. There's the sinker to start him out, missing down and away for ball one. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Blackmon is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two.
Might have been a good thing, huh?
Josh Donaldson will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. A splitter, but he started it too low as it bounces up to the plate.
Now, if he throws him a strike here, I think he's crazy, especially with an open base.
And a sinker is over that time. It's back to 2-1.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Shot toward right center.
And he Oh my gosh.
What a play there to end. Chris Davis will lead things off here for Houston as they look to get things started in this sixth inning.
Left fielder number two, Chris Davis.
And he takes ball one. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1.
And if he's getting tired, it's not showing in his slider. That pitch is still as tight as it was in the second inning.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And oh, we can't get out of the
God
way of that.
Dang
one,
it,
so
my
the
phone.
Man will be on to open the frame.
Darn it.
Now to the plate, Francisco Lindor. He singled his last time up. Snap throw from the catcher. And there he goes toward second. Hit on the ground down the first base.
Man!
And he is in there.
I had...
Nick Castellanos.
That is pissing me off.
For the third time now, he's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
Oh, my God.
Line drive to center field. That's in there. Base hit. And they're not.
Come on, you dummy! God! What is this? Really?
Stands in. He'll try to improve in this at-bat after grounding into a fielder's choice his last time up. And here's a fastball called for strike one. High in the air out to center field. Pollock shading to his right. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Oh, my God.
Caleb Joseph stands in. Was locked up on strike three in his last trip. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Runner goes for second. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. It's offline, but he's out. Gun down trying to swipe the base. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. Five runs, five hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Yeah, and on 1-2.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. A.J. Pollock will start things out for the Yankees here in their half of the sixth. Now some action out in the Houston bullpen as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Tanaka's ready. First pitch on the way. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
Eric Hosmer digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. Sent on the ground out to second. Altuve has it. Throw gets him. Two down.
The right fielder number is
Yasiel Puig digs in now after lining out in his last try.
Yeah, he put a good swing on it last time, so we'll see if he can make one fall here.
Ground ball left side, taken in by Castellanos. Throw on to fielders in time, and with that, the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They trail five. Darwin Barney is set to get us started for the late innings of this one. Gray gets the sign. Here's his offering. He'll go after the first pitch here as the fastball's hit foul off to the right. Strike one. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Awfully close with the slider there, but it's 1-1. Seemed to me like the wheels were coming off for this guy a bit in the sixth inning. Any surprise he's back out there for the seventh?
A little. I mean, this deep into a start, that's usually when you say, we'll let the bullpen take care of it from here. Apparently, though, they think he's got something left.
Jose Altuve comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. I know we have a tendency in the media to get hung up on pitch counts, but this is a legitimate workload he's sweated through so far.
Yeah, anytime you get up around that 110 mark, you put in a full shift, and he's fast approaching it here.
Charlie Blackman is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Set to deliver the 0-1. And it's quickly 0-2. Tried to work it back to that low inside corner, but it misses 1-2. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Okay.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches. I mean, he probably doesn't have a whole lot left in the tank, so the more you make him work, the better your chances of getting a mistake.
Good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count remains 3-2. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk. Prince Fielder will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk.
Yeah, nothing going on earlier in this inning, but a chance to make some noise right here. Those kind of walks often seem to come back and bite guys somehow.
Called to the bullpen here is the hard-throwing right-hander Joaquin Benoit gets the assignment. Prince Fielder is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
And with a runner on first, you better have a catcher that you can rely on if you're going to bounce a changeup on an 0-2 count. Luckily, he does.
5-2, our score as we play inning number 7. Frozen on the fastball, never had a chance, and the inning is over. Astros leave one. Leading off the inning, Ender Inciarte. And they'll need him to get something going here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
Up next for the Yankees.
Stephen Vogt, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
It was a pretty big strikeout, too, because he had a chance to drive in a run, so I'm sure he's going to be thinking about that missed opportunity for a little while.
Just gets a piece of it, strike one. He's set, here's the 0-1. Pitch out, nothing doing. Nobody out, runner on first. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Blackman is under it. And that's the first out of the inning. C.J. Krohn will take another shot here. He's flied out and lined out in two trips.
Well, 0 for 2, but he's taken some decent hacks. Could see a better result in this at-bat.
Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Blackman's after it. Two gone. Josh Harrison strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. He's set. Here it comes. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. A runner on first with two away. Hey. 1-0 pitch is a splitter in there, 1-1. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
Here's the 1-1 delivery. Nope. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
3-1 now.
And with that tying run on deck, he should get something good to hit right here, 3-1. If it's me, I'm looking for a fastball middle in.
Looking to avoid his first walk. And this pitch misses.
Right, I really need a home run.
So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away. Jonathan Villar will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
In the air now, out to right field. Victorino over to his left. And that retires the side. Yanks strand a pair. And leading off the inning, Chris Davis, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
And this pitch is right down the middle, strike one. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Digging in now, Francisco Lindor. He'll swing it from the left side right here. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. We're in the eighth inning now of a 5-2 ball game. Up top, it's 2-0.
And that fastball has definitely catches your attention, especially when it's on the inner half.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
Throw not in time, and he's in there with his third hit of the afternoon.
Third baseman
Nick Castellanos steps in after hitting an RBI single his last time around. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Benoit's ready. 0-1 pitch on its way. Chased out of the zone there, and he's down two strikes. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and here's the versatile outfielder, Shane Victorino. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Softly hit out to short. Throw in time, and the side is retired. One left for Houston. Josh Donaldson digs in to lead off the bottom of the eighth inning. And now K-Rod Francisco Rodriguez is up throwing in the bullpen. Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. It's a solo shot off the bat of Josh Donaldson. And it's a 5-3 game now. Luke Hochaver is on to work as he'll take over here in the eighth. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Now a swing, and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. And he's set down, one away.
The first baseman, number 35, Eric Hosmer.
Eric Hosmer digs in with one run in and one gone in the inning. And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. sinker. One ball, one strike. Down low, two balls and a strike. Cutter, and that's a called strike two. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
I think it's pretty simple. The message here is stop leaning out over the plate. The pitcher's got to be able to work inside, so that's just a reminder there.
Davis will drift over to his right a few steps as he takes it for the second out. 66. Yasiel Puig will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. First offering on its way. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Blackman has it in his tracks, and the inning is over. The Yankees claw back a bit thanks to the home run. Caleb Joseph will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Pollock has a read on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Up next for the Astros,
Darwin Barney strides in, grounded out his last time through. Now a fastball, a bit too low here, it's ball one. One out, nobody on. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Benoit has the target, coming home with a 1-1 pitch. Oh, had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Hot shot on the ground is short. In time to first, and there are two away. Jose Altuve will step in, a ground out victim his last time.
Yeah, ground out last time, but you know, with his speed, that's kind of a big part of the way he plays the game. Put the ball on the ground and force the defense to make a clean, quick play on him, because if they don't, he's safe.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
When he's got that slider working the way he wants it, it can be such a weapon for him.
And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory.
Now, see if I can get two runs.
Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Nothing further. Francisco Rodriguez is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Striding in to start the ninth, Ender Inciarte, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And he's already been on base three times in this ballgame, so let's see if he can do it one more time.
Hit high and deep to straight right field. A leap there by Victorino.
Yes.
But that one's out of reach. A home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. As they pull within one here, it's now a 5-4 game. Standing in now, Stephen Vogt. Should look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. Now the Yankees, with their three home runs now, still have a ways to go to match their record for a single game. Twice in their history, they've hit eight of them. Most recently in 2007. Davis a range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. C.J. Crone will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Yeah, guys, he's got to be feeling a little bit like that dog that gets left out in the rain while the rest of the family's inside by the fire. I guess he's just not seeing what everyone else is.
There's the hard stuff from K-Rod to start him out. It's nothing and one.
No!
Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
Oh, just a little over-anxious right there. I guess he figured he had a pretty good gauge on that fastball, and he hoped he'd see it again, but he got the curveball instead.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. Fastball, strike three called, as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Josh Harrison strides into the box now, launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. First pitch on its way.
No!
Castellanos is there.
God.
The first will be in time to get him, and the Astros move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over.
Well, he did serve up the home run here to make this one a little bit more interesting. But in the end, he does get the job done.
God, nails so down annoying. The save.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. An entertaining game all in all, so if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our top player of the game.
Stupid fielding.
Yeah,
mistakes,
he was a thorn
in the side.
Look
at that. I beat him in hitting.
You'll see there,
still
he winds
lost.
Up with a three-hit ball game, and a couple of those were key hits that helped lead his guys to victory.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire...